Yeah, so last game I just took too much damage trying to commit to Samira.
It was funny. I had three country headliners given to me that game.
And I think the play was...
I don't know. I think I needed the level before I dumped him. I don't know. That was a tough call. Last gold on me. Got it.
No, Reforger. The only time I ever want a Reforger is whenever I Reforge. Otherwise, I never want a Reforger. Oh, we hit Punk early. Early Punk is usually something you want to think about playing. Early Mordekaiser is interesting, though. Dude. Unfortunately, there's a dude sitting on country, so I don't want to play it. Like, the real question is, do I hit the reroll button here or not? I probably don't. I need to make sure no one else is going to play Punk. Judging by the fact you already have, like, four Vi's. Okay, we are not playing Punk. Okay. So it's the right call to not buy that. That is very heavily contested. This is a very powerful one. I think we're gonna take this one. Nina Lawson's bad. Not making gold here is bad. We might have to sell both these Olafs. I also probably should have put the Crown Guard on Lilia. Don't know. That's a tough call. Play five superfan here. Well, then my superfan would be freaking you, so we're not going to do that. Actually sounds like a terrible idea.
I think I like Superfan more here. I think we want to look for probably rods here. I think as long as we get DPS items, we're fine. Yeah, as long as we get a rod or a tier, we're okay. I'm actually gonna level here. That's a dumb early thresh. I think we want Nico here. We might even just sell you right now. Well, if we had Gnar, we probably would, but we don't have Gnar. And you are probably better than Nico right now. Not having Thresh, though, feels bad. Like, just seeing him there and not taking him. I should win this. You can only hit one. Yeah, also, I don't want to pull out Kennen, because Kennen is actually, like, secretly, like, kind of busted. It's actually pretty stupid how good he is. I don't want to level to 6 here, so we'll just pre-level. I don't think that's that good for me. This is pretty good, but as is this. Wanted to put Nico in. Also, we did hit Viego. Who we can hold. The problem with Viego is that he's bad, and I made a Jewel Gauntlet this game. I literally just have not made items that are actually useful for him. Like, the only way Viego actually makes sense is if I can, like, really level hard here. 6 Mulcher. Okay. Wasn't gonna beat that. Item wise, we probably want a tier. But if the Karthus is there, I might just take it. Probably gonna reforge this belt. There's almost no way this belt's useful to me. Yeah, let's go ahead and reforge it. Okay, sword I can work with. Oh wait, I'm pretty sure Viego is actually better than you. I guess we just level from here then. We're gonna hold on to these items though, because it just depends on whether we get stuff for Akali or whether we get stuff for Karthus. Probably should actually put Akali here. Oh, there's a one-star Mordekaiser. I might not win this one. Oh, I did win it. That was a one-star Mordekaiser. I don't like that either. That works. Now we just gotta figure out these items. I wish I had a lot more swords. We'll need another support item. We were never gonna take that. We'll actually just sell you and put both of those items on you. Yeah. I think we need to increase your survivability from there. And we'll have to figure out the rest of these items. It might make the most sense to give you the Quicksilver. I think Kennen actually makes sense here. I think I just need to put in Lilia, and this is actually a pretty good comp. Yeah, we want the Viego tier. We need to make sure we get like one tier item on Karthus. I don't even think it really matters what that tier item is. It needs to be a tier item. It might end up being an adaptive. Just depends on. I'm gonna have to wait to see what we get there. I think the real question is, do I want to level here or do I want to roll? I think I want to roll because I think hitting Lilia is a pretty big deal for my comp. Okay, I guess we just level. We're healthy enough, I think we can level from here. And then fully roll down. I also need to position better, because, again, this is not the best positioning. There is a world where I go 7 pennant kill, though. Where I just sell you and just take a York. Move all these items to York. But basically, if I hit York before I hit a Collie 2. Again, my positioning needs to get better here. It's actually closer than it looked. But items are a big discrepancy right now. We need to level and get some items. This is actually like pretty terrible way that I have to position for that. Tier? No tier. Okay. Shit. So we slammed the adaptive. I really wanted to go to 3-star more, but I don't think that's gonna happen. Why are you there? Shouldn't I actually put something else in? It's fine. Alright, what are we gonna do from here? Do we roll or do we go 9? I think we go 9. Because we're not gonna 3-star things from here. I'm not sold on Akali. Like, this is actually, like, good items to have for Yorick if I can hit Yorick. So I think the answer is to go 9 from here. Flubby's also pretty weak, I think. I think there's a couple players that are pretty strong. Crowd Diver's a little tricky. You've hit way too late. This is an interesting one, though. Because this comp's annoying. That's why it's interesting. Static might have been overkill here. I might have just wanted just a generic defensive item. I can always just reroll both of those. I don't think I need to, though. I think I just want GS. I could also take the Akali. But I think I kind of like GS here. Now we've had 3-stars. 2-star Akali. RIP. Yeah, let's just level here. I don't see a lot of value in just sitting here. See if we hit York and try to go for Pentakill 7. Well, I don't think 7 makes sense. Yo, this double crown guard plus this is actually pretty cracked. This double crown guard plus IS on Mort is actually insanity. It's just like so much extra healing and so much more damage he does. Yeah, we just like try to find something to take out probably Kennen. I don't think Kennen does anything right now outside of giving you Omni-Ramp. I think just level and find something to put in. And if it's Yorick, we can just sell Akali and put those items on Yorick. We're probably more likely to sell you and put Akali back in. Yeah, that might even make more sense. Because I doubt you actually do much. So we level at 6-2. So we know we beat the punk guy. I don't think the punk guy has a chance of beating us. The Mosher's a bit iffy, because this is a very good unit. I beat him once, but if he actually like hits things, he's gonna be difficult. Punk guy we know we beat. Crowd Diver I haven't played in a while. What item do we want out of this? Shiv? No, probably not Shiv. Stone Plate might not be a bad idea, nor is Protector's Vow for more frontline. I think it's just Protector's Vow. Protector's Vow on Nico. Alright, and we level up next turn. I don't think positioning would, like, change at all. Oh. Aw, rude. How is my Akali not dead? Lol. Alright. Yeah, my Akali being 2-star prevented me from winning that fight. We just gotta find stuff to put in. Hello? Yo, Quiana just destroyed that fool. By the way, how do I not have in KDA? I have Nico, Lilia. What did I? Oh, Akali is not in. How is what? Where is my what? Nani? All right, we'll have to fix that. Good news is I won this round. I don't. My Akali switched to true damage when it should be KDA. None of these are good. Red buff. I was like, none of these are good. We'll just take red buff. Yeah, so Akali. Want the true damage, which means we take you out, put Akali back in, then put in true damage. Oh, it's all messed up. Shit. Alright, we're just gonna go like that then. Yo, that was all FUBAR. Yeah, because it's Akali. Okay, so the Akali's KDA now. All right, I don't know what's happening. So the Akali's KDA now. So we should be okay on that. Weird. All right, we got a top two. I don't know if we beat. I think we can beat this guy, but his positioning is really kind of messing with me. So we need to figure out something we can hit that's actually going to help here and stop him from hitting Ziggs. Mm. Oh, we won that. Yeah, combat in this match is actually kind of crazy. I'm debating selling him to get a new chosen. It's a pretty dangerous play, especially when I just won a round. So we'll see how the next round goes. Emshin Stoneblade, Last Whisper, Deathblade. You a good Deathblade user? Not really. These items kind of suck. I'm not gonna lie. Maybe it's just blue buff. Okay, that's better. I didn't position again. Oh, we crushed him. We're not. No, it's only 2 minute loss, though. Alright, it was a good try. I think that was always going to be a little tricky to win, but I think it was a good second. I think Morkaiser might have been stronger there. Like, I'm not really sure what I could have rolled to make my comp any better. Like, Karthus was always going to have a hard time in that fight because there's just too much health on things. And he has a lot of backline access with Crowd Diver. I'm fine with it, whatever. We tried. I don't know, I feel like when I get all these 2-star 5 costs, actually, like, itemized too. Like, I should do better.